And now for some great conversation. Talking Circles with Chris Carter on Race 22 Radio.
Race 22 Radio.
Talking Circles with Chris Carter on Race 22 Radio is brought to you by Squeaky Clean Express, mobile vehicle wash and detail service. H&H Auto Repair of Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Turn and Burn Hobby and Raceway and Midway Embroidery and More, both located in the Midway Town Center in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. And Smokey Dave's Barbecue, located in Roxboro, North Carolina. We don't have interviews. We have rockin' conversation. And here's your host, Mr. Racing Entertainer himself, Chris Carter.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening to you, co-host Sydney Sanders. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Fat and happy. Dot Love, what's happening over there?
I'm good. Hope you are, man.
Number one producer in the entire planet and entire world.
Oh, stop. But tell me more.
I want to say quick before we get, I want to be serious for 1 second. Dang it, y'all. Freaking Beavis and Butthead in here, y'all. I'm telling you. Miss Dramatic, who says I'm dramatic. Anyway, prayers for Israel.
Absolutely.
There we go. Got to say that. You know, it's sad that we have our own country so divided on something like that. But you've got Israel, God's holy land, and you got Hamas and Iran terrorists. But anyway, let's remember them in our prayers. Also remember Miss Angie Smith. She is on the road to recovery. I did reach out to her today, but they got a lot going on. But anyway, remember Miss Angie Smith. She's having the skin grafts and all that done, but the recovery is coming along, and she's already said she's ready to get back on the NHRA pro bike.
She's tough as nails, y'all.
Imagine that. We're going to have a great show. We've got the South Boston Cars Tour winner, Deac McCaskill. And that's kind of, that reminds me, Dot Love, of, I want to say Trevor Ward winning at Martinsville.
Right.
The blue collar type deal. And also, speaking of Trevor Ward, he has shirts.
I saw those.
Trevor Ward Racing, MJ Graphics, of course, done that. So y'all go check out Trevor Ward Racing on Facebook. Yep. They've got some very nice shirts. Do you still got swag?
Yeah.
You still got stuff?
I do.
Okay. Sydney Sanders still has shirts and what else? Hoodies? Any hoodies?
Yeah.
I might need a hoodie. It's getting kind of nippy. Well, anyway, like I said, we got a great show tonight. Looking forward to it. We got a lot of kids on again. Y'all know how I am about the kids. We got Kevin Kromer of the Grand National Super Series. We're going to be racing at Carteret County Speedway this weekend. And I would like y'all to remember these beautiful, fine, amazing sponsors that is a part of this show that we appreciate so much. If you would, please, ma'am.
Of course. We have H&H Auto Repair in Winston-Salem, Pulliams Hotdogs in Winston-Salem, the Wake Tree Service serving the Triad area. Tea Time Sports and Spirits in Winston-Salem, Burke Street Pub in Winston-Salem, Captain's Retreat at Bear Creek, Squeaky Clean Express in Winston-Salem, Velocita USA, Motorsports on Main and Lexington, the DL Outfitters, Colfax Towing and Auto Repair, Cogar Plumbing, Ever Ready Mixed Concrete, J&T Services, CNC Lock and Key, Thunder Road Grill, Midway Mobile Storage, Midway Music Hall and Event Center, 5 Points Tire and Auto, Eric Messer Photography, and Make TV Great with Nate.
Want to say, hey, look who's already chiming in. That when Daniel Harrison of H&H Auto
P1.
You know, this could be a, he's already in early. You know how they are toward the end of the show.
He's already wound up. Yeah. Clayton Gerald in the house. Thank you.
Want to say thank you to Daniel Harrison, H&H Auto, one of our, they've been with us. Him and Philip been with the show since the beginning. Randy Lookabill. Hey, Chris. DL Outfitters, looking forward to you coming down with the guys for the bear hunt. So it's going to be Daniel Harrison, Jason Rowell, who owns Colfax Towing and Auto Repair, also sponsors this show. So, hey, Chris, Cindy and Doc Love. I love watching your podcast. I love
that's awesome.
You.
Thank you.
Talk to her today. She is getting over some COVID symptoms. Aww. So she's by herself hanging out. So maybe we can put a smile on your face. You know I love you. And I'll be down Friday. We're racing at Carteret County Speedway. There's Jason Rowell. He ain't going. Oh, yeah. I'm going, boy.
You're going bear hunting?
I'm going, boy.
He's going to cook.
I'm going to be.
He's going to do like I did with Steve.
DeWalt and him.
DeWalt and him down at the World Series of Asphalt Everyday Racing for a week.
New Smyrna.
Yep. New Smyrna.
All right. Well, anyway, thank y'all so much for tuning in. We're going to have a good time tonight, or at least we're going to try to. If you see me drinking out of a cup, this is something that Cindy has provided with me.
And it's his new favorite.
It's Halloween.
Doc Love said the face. Doc Love said the face I made when I tried it. I think it's like some kind of moonshine, a crackhead out of Theodore, Alabama, mate. I don't know. Anyway, all right. Have I said how much I love y'all? Thank you for tuning in. We're gonna get right to it. He has been on Sydney. I don't know if he was with me when he was on the show.
I don't think so.
But this young man right here, y'all gonna love him. I promise. He's a hoot, and he is a one heck of a driver. And his name is Kenan Brown. He's a 9-year-old quarter midget racer, and he's out of Troy, North Carolina, and he won his junior Honda Heat last Thursday. And that put him, now listen to this, y'all. That putting him in the A main P4. On the start, he got pushed to the back, dead last. Kenan worked his way back up to the front, and listen who passed him. The little kid, his name's Brexton Bush. Okay. You tell him, buddy. I'm gonna let him know. That's Kyle Bush's son, who is amazing. So Brexton Bush passed him at the end, and then Kenan took it back on the last lap, and he is your Charlotte Motor Speedway NASCAR Youth Series Junior Honda winner, Kenan Brown. And Kenan, thank you, buddy, for being back on. How are you, man?
Good. How are you?
Boy, I'm still fat and happy. So, Kenan, man, you have had a lot going on since the last time you was on the show, and I guess I might as well get right to it. How cool was it to outrun Brexton Bush? Be honest.
It was crazy. Like, I thought he was just going to backpass me every single time I passed him. I thought he was just going to, like, go past me every single time. And I was like, he's going to pass me. And I was like, he's not passing me. So I was like, okay, I'm just going to keep on going. So I just kept on going. And then he finally passed me. And then I passed him back. It was white flag. He passed me. I passed him back on the back straightaway. And then I stayed beside him for turn 3 and 4. And I won the race.
That's awesome.
So let me ask you this. Did Brexton's dad, Kyle Bush, did you get to talk to him any, or did you interact with him? Or even his mom, Miss Samantha, did you get to interact with him when y'all were racing?
I mean, not whenever I was racing, but I did see him at the racetrack.
Did you kick him in the knee?
Mean?
No, it ain't. He'd probably kick.
I have a Kyle Busch car, and I actually got him to sign it.
Oh, so cool!
I took that car. Yeah, his trailer was not too far from mine. I walked over there, and I got him to sign it. And I was just like, Brexton was like he was talking to me, like silently. He wasn't saying anything. He was telling me to do. To get him to sign my car.
Right.
And I was like, hey, can you sign this car for me? And he was like, yeah. He grabbed a Sharpie and signed the windshield of it.
That's cool. And Braxton helped you do that. I was going to ask you, did you interact with Braxton?
Yes.
He seems like a really fun kid.
I played with him like a lot at the racetrack. Like I was playing with him in between races, like before even the A mains, like I was playing with them. I don't know, like every day almost, really.
So, Kenan, next time y'all are racing and you see this kid, I want you to say, Braxton, too bad you can't be on the coolest podcast in the entire country. I was on Chris Carter's show. You point at him too, say, get some of that, boy. I've been on there more than once. I've been on Chris Carter's podcast.
Bless.
I mean.
Right? Yeah. You mean, this is twice you've been on here. Look, we got a lot of fans too. You people has asked me about you since you was on the first time. So I always keep up with what you're doing. And I'm like, you know what? I text your dad and I said, I need to have Kenan on again. And look, here we are. We're on our Cam's Corner segment. And this is brought to you by Pulliams Hot Dogs and Barbecues. So what else has been going on? I heard or seen that you went to also Darlington. How was that?
It was good. Well, kind of. I didn't do very good in my animal, but in the Honda, I was in the B main. I can't remember where I started. I think started third, I think. Yep. And I won that one, so I started seventh in the A main. Came up and finished second behind my friend. His name is Rue Reeves. And he raced also at Charlotte. He was the one that I can't remember where he finished in the A main, but he was in there, and he was just somewhere. I don't know where, but
right, that's right.
He was, I think, sixth. I think
we'll go with that, sixth.
Yeah, but Darlington, he won that race. He was happy, and at where is it? Charlotte. He actually won his car, one of his cars. The car's name is called a Junior 160. It's kind of like my car, but it's a Junior 160. It goes, I have a light 160, but yeah. It goes, like, the Junior 160 and light 160s goes, like, the same speed.
Right.
So, it was just fun to be with all them kids and race with all them, like, they're aggressive, they're passing really aggressive. It's just so great to be racing with all these kids. Like, they're so fun to race with.
And that's, you'd rather be racing than anything on the planet, wouldn't you, buddy?
Yeah.
So, okay, but the history, Kenan, of being at Darlington Raceway has to be really, really awesome for someone as young as you. I mean, you're nine, and that track has so much history. I mean, it's you know, pretty awesome, wouldn't you think, Darlington?
Yeah, I've never been there.
And also at Charlotte, so you've been awful busy. How much more racing do you have to go before Santa Claus comes? Does Santa Claus even come to your house?
Yeah.
Okay. So how many more races do you got before he comes and hangs out with you or slides down your chimney?
I think six.
Wow.
Five or six.
That's a lot of more races left.
Are they local or far away?
Local. Well, there's three, like, local races that I might win the championship in.
Uh-huh.
Cool.
And then I got a big race, like a big race. And then I have another one that I might win the championship in. So they're all locals. And so.
That's cool. Do you remember, it wasn't that long ago, I was still, Bowman Gray was still racing. And so it had to have been before August. Do you remember when I came and watched you? Boy, we took a picture together.
I do remember that.
Man, you're gonna make me cry on my own podcast if you didn't remember that. Yeah, come over there and took a picture. I got to watch you. It was fun. Actually, I was over there with a Bubba Gale with a little Sebastian. But anyway, I got to watch you, so that was really cool. So you've got a chance to win more than one championship. Is that correct, Kenan?
Yes, sir. I have. It's something called a Dixie Shootout Series. And then I have a championship series that I can win in both ends.
Wow.
Man. That's
awesome.
That is awesome.
You got some fans in the chat, Kenan. Bethany Adams, her middle name is
good
Hocamp. Just say, she says, yay, KB. And then she said, you should have gave Kyle Busch something to sign.
I have the same initials as Kyle.
That's true. KB. That's true. Yeah. She said, Kyle, you should have get, you know, Kyle, you should have got, or Kyle should have got your autograph on something.
She is one of my teachers. Well, she's not my teacher, but I know her at my school.
Oh, cool.
She's a second grade teacher, and I've always, like, I've been hanging out with her for
With a teacher.
Boy, did you hear mom laughing in the background?
So look, whatever Miss Bethany, I mean, surely she doesn't have to get y'all to say this middle. I'm scared to say it. She might get mad at it.
It's Hocamp.
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 That's actually her last name teacher. It's a fifth grade, I think, teacher.
I'm just gonna say, I bet Miss Adams is one cool teacher.
Yeah.
She's tuning in tonight, so she is awesome in my book, and I do appreciate you, Miss Adams.
David Culp says, Hocamp. Go, boy.
Hocamp Adams. Yeah.
That's awesome.
So what's your favorite track to race at?
That's hard.
Well, let me think now.
Okay, top three.
A lot of fun. Probably New Smyrna.
Okay. Oh, wow.
Really?
That's where I actually won this right here up.
What? I can't see it.
Right there.
Oh, I gotta scroll up. Oh, show it.
Gosh, that looks heavy.
No.
Boy, heck yeah.
Well, that's a gator head. Lord have mercy.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, kiddo.
That's awesome.
So, I was racing at New Smyrna, what y'all were talking about. Before the show started, y'all were talking about New Smyrna. And the big, we race inside of the big track.
Right.
Yeah. Like, you know, if you're ever racing there, if you're going into turn one and two, then there's a track in the middle of turn one and two. And you can see it probably whenever you're going around the track.
Yep. I saw it down there.
Yeah.
So guess what?
There's alligators in it.
I had alligator last night.
Boating balls.
I had boudin. I had boudin balls and alligator last night. And it was really good. I had the alligator, grilled alligator over a bed of rice at Razoo's. And it was so good. So now Kenan's showing us an alligator head. Next time I see you, I'll bring some alligator, okay?
Okay.
Would you try frog legs?
I don't know about that one. Did you know the picture that you showed up earlier where I was carrying the checkered flag?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There's another car that I have. It was actually like kind of born in New Smyrna. Like it raced a lot there. It's called a Bulldog. And that picture that you just showed up, that's a 24 bullet. And my other one.
Is this a different one?
Here it was. But it was some year, and I can't remember.
Hey, it doesn't matter, buddy.
That's right.
It was some year,
and you were still winning.
I can't remember. I think it was. I really don't know, but it's called that one that you just showed up. That's a bullet, and there's two different kinds. It's a bullet and a bulldog. Those are two of my favorite cars.
Oh, yeah?
Wow.
So, yeah.
That's cool. So, you've won a lot in those cars, huh?
Yes.
That's
40
awesome.
Races in total. 40, wow. 41, I think.
Mom or dad was going live during the races this past weekend. I got to watch several of those clips. Man, it looked like some good, close, tight racing. When you're out there playing with, you know, the other drivers and having fun, being friends. Now, when you get on the track, do you have any friends?
No. Whenever I put my helmet on, I don't have any friends anymore.
That's right,
come and give me a fist bump before the race.
That's right.
Like, that's the only time they're friends with me.
You should do like
after the race and before the race.
Like when they go to fist bump you?
No.
What?
You can do it after the race. Well, Kenan, man, it's time that I have to say goodbye to you. But, you know, as always, we can't say goodbye without you thanking everybody that helps you out on your race car and whoever else.
Okay, so my sponsors are Friendly Chevrolet, Bumgarner Family Funeral Service, Velocita Brown's Mowers, Bullet Chassis, Steve's Auto Repair, and I think that's all.
I think you've left some people out, some very important people.
Yeah.
I think you did. Now, we're going to work on it. That's why, hey, Kenan, and when I say this, this is why, for those of y'all watching, listen, this is why I have these kids on the show, is things like this, because it's important to thank mom and dad. Regardless of the role they play, you always got to thank your mom and dad, okay?
And I want to thank my mom and dad.
There you go.
Yeah.
Every time we do these cup races every year, and always I go, my mom and dad and the rest of my sponsors. Like, mm-hmm. I have to like look over at my car and see what sponsors I have.
Late model drivers do it, and they do it at Bowman Gray. All levels of drivers do that, so that's okay.
A lot of times they try to take my microphone when I announce a race so they can walk around the car like, give me my damn microphone. Anyway, and there's nothing wrong at your age, Kenan. Listen to me and remember this. There is nothing wrong at your age with having a piece of paper. Yeah. And there's nothing. I told you I was going to have you on. What the? Russians? Anyway, I told you I was going to have you on again, and I want to have you on again before Christmas. How's that sound?
Okay.
All right, buddy. Thank you again. It's good to talk to you, all right?
All right.
Bye.
Peace, buddy. Peace out, White Trout.
Oh, is he sharp or what? I love that
guy. As a thumbtack on Christmas.
It was fun, yeah.
Absolutely. How do you know? You didn't even talk to the kid.
Well, you was talking.
Well, I mean, you got
to. I talked to him, too.
You should have asked him what he was getting for Christmas when I said something about Christmas.
Now, Chris.
What?
Do you know what you want for Christmas?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, I don't know.
I wanted it for my birthday. I didn't get it, so I'm hoping I get it for Thanksgiving.
My kid's birthday is before Christmas, so. What just happened?
I said Thanksgiving.
Yeah, if I don't get it then hopefully I get it for Christmas.
All right. All you people walking. Justin Walker. Hey, brother.
Hey.
All right. As y'all can tell, we're going to take, hey, the D's Lug Nuts podcast. They're watching tonight.
Oh,
good.
Cool.
To check them out. Y'all check. Awesome. That's a good podcast. Good friends of ours. Yep. And the show is awesome that they're paying attention, watching us tonight. My name is Chris Carter. Her name is Cindy Sanders. My producer over there is Dan Doc Love. And we appreciate all of y'all, every one of y'all tuning in. Thanks for my awesome sponsors. We're going to take a quick break. This is Travis Grubb and the Stone Rangers. They're out of Kernersville, North Carolina. Y'all don't go nowhere, and if you do, please come right back.
We're gonna get so damn high, and never gonna see us again. Come on by today.
This segment is brought to you by H&H Auto Repair, located in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. H&H Auto Repair is your one-stop auto shop. They're located at 3088 Kernersville Road in Winston-Salem, family-owned and operated for over 20 years. There's no job too big or too small. H&H Auto is also an official North Carolina inspection station. Whether it's an oil change or an engine swap, go by and see the guys at H&H Auto, and be sure to tell them OCC sent you. H&H Auto Repair, 3088 Kernersville Road, Winston-Salem, North Carolina.
Next. DD?
Yep.
All I Got Best.
Oh, gosh.
This is Cam Brown from Cam's Corner on Race 22 Radio.
Nothing seems to fill this place. I need this every time. So take your last bit off my case. Someday I will find.
You should know the words by now.
I don't know.
Y'all should have seen her. She's like,
I had the nothing seems to fill this place.
In that song, they say addiction needs a pacifier. Don't think too hard on it. You'll hurt yourself. Never mind. Pretty good stuff. Of course, you know, everybody knows how much I love my Three Doors Down. Thank y'all for tuning in once again.
Hey, Haley.
Haley Brown in the house. I was this close, Haley, to calling you, getting you on tonight. And I forgot when you won your first race, I had you on that week. So you are more than welcome. My last call will be at 8:40. No, wait.
8:30.
Yeah.
We're off schedule, so it might be late.
I mean, better not be off schedule.
It's 7:27.
Oh, Lord. We're right. Anyway, Haley, if you want to call in after about 8:40-ish or whatever, you're more than welcome. We keep the mojo going, see, because this championship you've got to win this weekend.
Ooh.
But at Carteret County Speedway is
no.
Toodle Winks on here?
Nope. I sent them the information.
Well?
Hadn't heard back.
All right. Well, we'll talk about Haley Brown some more. Yeah.
Nothing seems to feel this. Okay. So is she in the lead?
No, she's 1 point back.
Ooh, wow.
Is this weekend championship night?
Yes.
Oh, my gosh.
1 point, my girl Haley Brown. And, well, I guess y'all know. I guess they know. She got her another race car. Yeah. She's been really, really busy. She's coming for your ass. I mean, your butt. She's coming for you.
Okay.
Yeah. And y'all can have like a dual powder puff race.
Powder puff.
Yeah. Okay, so 14-year-old Dee Dee White, she races in the Junior Mini Cup division at Carteret County Speedway, supposed to be calling in and all that, but sometimes they don't, but that's okay. I promise we have plenty to talk about. Haley gave us the checkered flag signs.
Checkered, checkered, checkered.
But anyway, wishing her the best this weekend.
So you're calling that race this weekend?
Yeah, I'll be at Carteret County. I'm going to MC the banquet for the Grand National Super Series. So that'd be cool. Yeah, Pee Wee, you tell Haley, get that championship. Haley Brown.
Who is in the lead by 1 point?
What's his name, Haley? Something Snow. Tim Snow, Jim Snow, Frank Who Snow, Bob Snow. I think his last name's Snow. You would think the announcer would know this.
I was about to say,
But it's a part-time, halftime announcing job. You know what I'm saying? Bowman Gray, then Carteret County. Then throw in a little Grand National Super Series in there, which they're going to have their championship night at Carteret County. Bob Snow. Yeah. Thank you, Haley, girl. Oh, huh. Bob Snow. Did I say Bob?
Yeah, you said like 10 names before.
Yeah, you did a good rundown.
But you got it.
Oh, Bob Snow. Yeah. LaVon Vance, Bob Snow. Okay. And speaking of tomorrow, 5:00 on Facebook, Bob Lowry is going to be making a big announcement about November the 11th. It's awesome. It's cool.
Is that the Nationals?
The day before.
The mini stock Nationals?
Yes. The day before. Travis Provost.
Yes.
Yes. That's the day before.
We're not racing on a Friday. That's Veterans Day.
Veterans Day is always on a Monday.
We're racing November 10th, November 11th. November the 10th is going to be the mini stock Nationals. And November 11th is going to be Night of Champions with a limited late model paying $10,000 to win.
Did you text Dee Dee? I can reach out. I got that number.
Huh.
Well, it's almost time. We're just going to move on. Don't worry about it. Don't. Okay. No, I'm not going to.
We'll get her next time.
Yes, absolutely. She knows. I'll see her this weekend. Yeah,
that's rough.
What?
Friday night?
What? Are you just learning this?
Yeah, because it did say 11th and 12th.
When?
On the Carolina Mini Stock page.
Did it?
Yeah.
Did Travis make a boo-boo?
Because, I mean, a lot of people are going to be coming from out of town.
You think?
That means I got to take off work.
I mean, are
November 11th, 2023 schedule, Carteret County Speedway Nationals.
November the 10th is the race, if you look on their website.
I just did.
That ain't Carteret County's thing. Did you see what you just done? Do that again.
Ooh.
This ain't Steven Sanders. All right. So anyway, Carteret County Speedway this weekend is going to be a big weekend. They're going to have the USAC Midgets Dot Love. The Midgets are going to be there as well as the Grand National Super Series. And speaking of, we're going to have Kevin Kromer on here in a little bit. But also, I want to say, I can get into the stuff that I was going to say at the end of the night. I want to congratulations to Mr. Bobby Labonte winning the Smart Modified Tour race at Tri-County.
Tri-County, yes, I watched it.
Fun.
I went blank for a minute. I do that often. Jeff Odom, yep, I will see you this weekend, my brother. Looking forward to it. Always love going to Carteret County. Always. What'd I do? Who was that?
Travis Provost.
Did we say a boo-boo?
He said it's on the 11th. We can get that figured out later.
When your co-host, when your co-host, I've told you. Okay, so they're going to do it the same day, and it's not a two-day event then. Is that where we're going with this?
Correct.
Okay. All right. Well, Carson Gilligan just text. All right. So it's 7:33. We're going to have Deac McCaskill home here in just a minute. I would say y'all call in and tell us a story or something, but we ain't going to do that. Somebody might be mean or something, but we're going to take a break and we'll be right back. Don't go nowhere. And if you do go somewhere, come right back.
It's going to be on the 11th, Chris Carter.
I did not say that. I said. Keep giving out misinformation.
Looking for tomorrow.
Never. I might have it next time.
People can trust me to detail their vehicle because I've been doing it for years. I've worked on stuff from $1,000 all the way up to $100,000, but at the end of the day, you still gotta live up to the same standard. I put love and care into every vehicle. I just want to make sure my customer's happy because I like getting everything. I mean, every crack, every cranny, anything I can get. I really just want it to be squeaky clean. I know how I want my ride to look like at the end of the day, and I should do the same thing to yours.
Kale Gale, and you're listening to Race 22 Radio.
She said life's a lot to think about sometimes when you're living the lights and all the stars sparkle and shine every day.
I knew that.
She said life's so hard to move in sometimes.
We call them three trailers down back home. Three doors down. Gotta love them. So anyway.
He has a correction to make.
I do. I hate it when I'm wrong, but I was wrong. But the Saints won this weekend and Alabama won. So you just take that before I go forward with this comment. But I was wrong. November the 11th, November 12th. I mean, I could have texted Travis for you instead of Facebook messaging him during the show. Well, he'll call in too. He's always on before we do this race, so he'll be on in the next 2 weeks or so. You like it when I'm wrong. I almost canceled the show. I want y'all to know that ever since the Coleman deal and all, I have issues. It only happens ever so often. So I almost canceled tonight. And I was until Dot said Deac was confirmed, and you can't do that to somebody like that. So here we are. If you see me rubbing my eye, it ain't because
Sydney's making me. It's because he's sad because I made him. He was wrong.
Yeah, I was wrong, wasn't I? So it's a Saturday and Sunday show.
Yeah.
Yeah. Saturday and Sunday show. It'll be a good one, too. Is Steven going to be in it?
I'm not sure.
Is AJ?
Yeah.
Should have figured. So anyway, all right, coming up next, we're going to have Deac McCaskill, and then we're going to have Kevin Kromer, and then we're going to have a little 15-year-old, an Italian-American, a really neat story we're going to have with him. Hey, Miss Kelly, I see you on here watching. Miss Kelly Kromer, that's Kevin's wife who will – she reminds me of Bubba Pollard's sister. You know what I'm saying? Spotter, jack man, jack woman, take the cop. She's not scared to
get her hands dirty.
No, no, not Miss Kelly. But she'll cook a buffet for you at the end of the race.
Oh, I love that.
Oh, I bet you do. You can tell I do. Michael Bivens is on last week. He's watching. I'm going to say hey to him. Thank you for tuning in. And
we have a friend.
We have someone on the air. Deac McCaskill, is that you, buddy?
Yes, sir.
Deac, how are you, my friend? Appreciate you calling in tonight.
Yeah, man. Doing good. Appreciate you guys having me on.
Yeah. Want to let the listeners and everybody know this is Deac McCaskill, who won the Cars Tour race at South Boston last weekend. This segment is brought to you by Cogar Plumbing. And one, like I said, appreciate you being on. Man, I kind of compared you. No, I didn't kind of compare Deac. I'm lying. I compared you, your win to me, me personally. Was similar to what Trevor Ward done at Martinsville. In other words, it's the blue collar man. You know, everybody loves Deac McCaskill. You probably don't believe that, but they really do. You're a big fan favorite. And when I seen that you won that race, I was like, you know, that's awesome. And tell us about it, man. Had to be a great night for not only you, your family, and everybody involved.
Yeah, it sure was. Yeah, you're right about the competition, man. It's as strong as ever. Some of these teams we're up against this year is just it's just crazy, man. I never thought late model stock racing would come this far, but it really has this year. And to get a win, to really get two wins on the Cars Tour season is really, really special. We just put a good package together this past weekend, had a good qualifying effort, and got out front, got in clean air, just had the top line, you know, working pretty much about the whole race, and just made it really, really hard for Lane to get around me. He raced me really hard. We got a lot of respect for each other, and just glad we could put on a good show for the fans. Everybody seemed to enjoy it.
Definitely enjoyed it. Let me ask this. You were talking about how competitive the Cars Tour is, and I agree 110% how the competition has picked up. Is this some of the hardest competition that you've seen as far as this goes in your career?
Yes, yes, no doubt. These last couple of years has gotten just extremely hard. You can look at, you can just look at qualifying, how close the times are. You know, a tenth off, you're anywhere from tenth to 12th, you know. And years past, if you were tenth off, you could still get in the top five. So, it's just really hard, man. You got to be 100% prepared each and every race. Back when I was growing up at, just at local tracks, you know, we only had one big show to look forward to. That was, you know, pretty much Martinsville every year. And now we have like 16 big shows to get ready for.
Right, yeah.
It's just crazy the amount of effort you got to put in. And I was really in shock to beat some of these teams. That 62 cars has really been fast right out of the gate. And, just to outrun them guys is just really, really special.
And for the listeners, for y'all listening at home that doesn't know, the 62 car he's referring to is the car that's owned by Kevin Harvick, is Lane Riggs, who is a wheel man within himself, too. Let me ask you this, Deac. Since Dale Earnhardt Jr., Kevin Harvick himself, Justin Marks and Jeff Burton has taken over the Cars Tour. do you feel like, and I do, I mean, this is kind of a dumb question to be honest, but the future of the Cars Tour, I feel like this is just the beginning of something that, that is really going to go a long way. I feel like this could possibly compete with NASCAR.
Yeah. Yeah. I think you're going to start seeing a lot of manufacturers, you know, get involved, you know, Chevrolet, Toyota, Ford, and looking for that next, you know, young driver. And to be honest, I really think Josh Berry has really opened the doors up for these people to see, like, you know, where did this guy come from? They look back at the Cars Tour and, you know, just kind of make it a good stepping stone for the, you know, moving up the ladder, you know, trucks, Busch, or I'm sorry, Xfinity and Cup.
I'm with you, Deac. It's always the Busch series to me. I'm with you.
Yeah. I'm old school, but it's just, I just really think, you know, Josh has really opened up the door for a lot of these younger drivers, and including Lane. You know, he's a heck of a driver, and he's got a, you know, a couple of things going for him this year, and I hope he can make the best of it because he definitely deserves it.
Right. I know Doc Love is dying to talk to you.
Yes, sir.
You know, Deac, I've known you for a long time. I see a couple of years ago, you kind of went through a drought and you said, man, you know, this is special. I don't know if I'll ever win again. Well, you end up with the RNS cars and you got two victories this year. I don't think Deac McCaskill is done anytime soon. What do you think?
I sure hope not. This weekend definitely felt really good to get back and, you know, in victory lane and feel like I can still do it. Cause you know, you go through a dry spell and you start, you know, questioning yourself. You know, a lot of drivers say that, and it's the truth. You know, you start wondering if you've lost it or what it is, but it definitely feels good to get back in front and know you're capable of doing it.
And I know it's special to have your family there. It was awesome. I watched it online to see you and your family there, getting all the pictures there. I'm going to share it with everybody. And, man, you couldn't have been more proud. And I know it's very special, especially when you win, when your family's there, because I've seen you win when your family's not there. It's got to be special because you guys are so close and your wife has overcome so much and she's looking fantastic, brother.
Yeah, I appreciate it, man. She is really, really, really looking good this year and just really proud of her. I'm glad she was there. And both my girls, having them there, you know, my dad, man, my brother-in-law helps me out. My son-in-law, Hunter, he spots for me and kind of helps me work on the car a lot. So it's definitely a total family affair is what we put together. Just really special just to see them guys, the excitement on their faces when you pull into victory lane, man. Just nothing tops it.
Yeah, I'm going to, real quick, I'm going to share a picture that, you know, like I said, I've known you for a long, long time, Deac. And I never knew this about you. And I'm showing a picture of you at Soldier Field. What the heck is that all about? Chicago Bears? Are you kidding me?
Yeah, man. I've been a big Bears fan since I was a little kid, you know, growing up and when they won the Super Bowl with McMahon and Walter Payton and the refrigerator, I just got hooked as a little kid. So I've just been pulling for them. And I've always wanted to go to a Bears game, and Sandy surprised me 2 weeks ago on a Tuesday night, my birthday, and she had me tickets for that coming up weekend to go to the Soldier Field and watch a game. So I was kind of surprised.
That's awesome.
For sure. So, yeah, we took off, me and her, and had a great time. We lost, but we still had a blast.
That's right. Win or lose, it's as a fantastic getaway. What a nice surprise. Happy birthday, by the way. Mine was Sunday.
Yeah.
And I'm the same way. I've never been to a Packer game live. I want to go, and I don't care if they win or lose. It'd just be awesome just being there. But thought that was really awesome. That was a fantastic surprise.
Is everybody?
Thank you. Yeah, it was.
Is everybody gathering what's going on here? I mean, if you look right over here in this corner, we have this diehard Doc Love Green Bay Packers that play football in the gates of heaven. And now we got our guest who loves the Chicago Bears in the same way. who both teams suck, by the way. Okay.
No argument.
Chris.
No argument.
Now, wait a minute, Dee. This is coming from a diehard New Orleans Saints fan who the Packers beat. So
at least I got that. And so, they beat Chicago. So
Dee, let me ask you this. Yeah. This is funny we're even talking about this. One of my sponsors, H&H Auto here in Winston, one of the brothers, Philip, that is, he loves the Bears. He loves the Chicago Bears. And today,
all right,
I was at, I think he might have left, but is Refrigerator still alive? Prairie.
Man, that's a good question.
Number 72.
I don't know.
Because he said he thought something happened to it being a diabetic and his legs might, one of his legs might got amputated or something. But I was wondering, is Refrigerator Perry, William Perry, still alive?
Yeah, I'd have to look that one up. I don't know.
I think Doc was doing it for us.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let's see. Well, your Bears, I think Justin Fields, myself personally, I think he's a good quarterback. I think he's going to be fine. The dude can sling a football from Riley to Winston. So,
yes, he is still alive. Lives in Aiken, South Carolina.
Really?
He's 60 years old. Yes. No longer the size of a refrigerator. He's more of a kind of a side, like a college room, like kind of like my little refrigerator, like my little refrigerator.
Well, I am another reason, because I'm from Mississippi, Deke, and Walter Payton went to Jackson State. So, I've always liked Walter Payton. And I'm pretty old. I've actually got to watch Walter Payton when he played at Jackson State, actually. So, this was just like an awesome, we should have had done a group hug or something. We all just bonded over football. Can you believe this? Cindy, can you tell Deke McCaskill hello? Hey, believe it or not,
y'all been talking.
Deke, I do have a co-host. This is Cindy Sanders.
Hello, Deke.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good. Congratulations on your win.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
So the last time, and y'all was talking about your family and everything, I'm trying to be a little serious now again. You talking about your family and everything, and I know you don't remember it because you was running all over the place, was I was with Bubba Pollard, and I want to say it was at North Wilkesboro, because I think Jake Finch was on the other side of Bubba Pollard, and y'all were next to us, or either next to us or another trailer down.
Yeah, we were right beside Bubba, yeah.
Yeah, and your girls and all, I can say, it was a family affair that evening, and it was pretty cool seeing y'all all working together. Them girls don't joke around either, do they?
No, they don't. No, they love it more than I believe I do. And speaking of Bubba, man, my wife is just a huge Bubba Pollard fan. And we were able to park beside him, and man, she was just hog heaven being with Bubba, because we met a couple of years ago through over at Hickory through Lee Pulliam. Matter of fact, Lee introduced me and Sandy to Bubba, and he had heard about what all she had been through, and man, he just sat there and took the time and out of his busy schedule and sat there and talked to her for a long time, and just, man, she thought the world of that. So we're really both are really big Bubba fans, so just really cool to park beside him that day at Wilkesboro.
Bubba Pollard, I've done PR for Bubba. I've been in Victory Lane numerous times with Bubba Pollard. I've got to do his Twitter and some really big races. We're very good friends. And a lot of people misunderstand Bubba because they look at this big corn fed Georgia boy. But it's people like your wife that he is, that means a lot to him, and people's stories like that. He takes it all in, and he will, when he sits and listens, he's really listening,
Yeah.
But let me tell you this, Dee. Yeah. He has got he's fixing to have a podcast.
That's what I was getting ready to say.
It's called BSing with BP.
Okay.
Oh, all right.
Yep.
So, be sure and tell Sandy about that.
Yes. Yes.
I wish I wish we lived closer so I could produce it for him. I would love to produce a podcast for him, but it ought to be very entertaining, to say the least.
And the thing about Bubba is, right now, a while ago when a guest didn't call in, and it kind of worked itself out, I could text Bubba Pollard and say, "I need you to call in." And Dot Love, am I lying?
He'll call in. He'll say, "What y'all doing?"
Nobody's been on this. Yeah. Nobody, Deke, nobody's been on this show more than Bubba Pollard. I mean, that's
awesome.
Yep, he's a good guy. Awesome. But I'll send you the information on the podcast. I asked him, did he want to call in tonight and talk about it, and it's not ahead far enough to you know,
promote it yet.
Yeah,
gotcha.
Not yet, but it will be.
Good deal.
So, Deac, what do you have a favorite track that the Cars Tour races on?
Oh, well, somebody asked me that earlier this year, and I like all of them, and there's just a couple that I have really good, really trouble at, and that's Florence and Ace. And it ain't that I don't like them, I just ain't figured them out yet. So, but yeah, all the other ones, man, I enjoy all the tracks we go to. I really don't have a specific favorite, but I just there's a couple I just struggle at and I need to get better at. I don't like them or dislike them. I just need to get better at them.
And when you go to South Boston, we looked at the records. You got 10 victories there on the weekly racing series. When you go to some of these tracks, is that one of the tracks that you've won the most at outside of the Cars Tour?
Probably Southern Nationals is the track I've won the most at.
That's right.
Yeah, back in
what was I thinking?
I think 12. Yeah, 12 and 13. We won quite a few races there, but we got a lot of wins at Orange County, you know, where I started racing at, and you know, we went to South Boston for, I want to say 08 through 10 or 11. We were there full time and picked up we got two of them July 4th races we won, and that was pretty special.
Sweet.
But yeah, we've always had a good time going up there. The track looks, I mean, it looks amazing. All the hard work that gets put in and week out up there, you can tell it just looks really good.
Yeah, I gotta say, you know, being part of South Boston these days, watching it on the on Flow Racing, I thought it looked spectacular, and with the fair in the background on some of the shots, I thought that was really cool.
So
yeah,
that was last weekend, right? We're talking about.
Yeah.
Okay, so was that like the South Boston Speedway Fair, or was that the South
Boston County Fair?
County Fair?
Yeah.
How awesome County. Is that?
Yeah.
That was pretty neat. I thought it was like somebody for promotional reasons put a Ferris wheel in the background or something.
Well, they had a Ferris wheel at Charlotte.
Yes. But I didn't know, but that is pretty cool. So, Deac, what the new, what's his name? Brandon Brown? Is that his name?
Yeah.
Dot Love? What's your thoughts on Brandon Brown? Do you know much about him, Deac?
No, I sure don't. I've heard the name, and I met him for the first time this weekend at Victory Lane, but seems like he's, you know, really good guy. I think he's got a lot of energy and excitement bringing to the track. So, you know, we'll see what the future holds next year.
I'm looking forward to seeing he's got, and Dot Love, I think you can attest to this. Mm-hmm. That he's got big shoes to fill.
He does.
I liked Chase.
Chase and Carly did a fantastic job. And Deac is right. He's got a lot of energy, Brandon Brown. I met him through Dave C when I was doing some podcast stuff with them. And so we became friends, and he's done a lot of cool things. I mean, he still was going down and helping produce or watching him produce some of the Door Bumper Clear podcast and stuff like that, and does a lot of material work for NASCAR, you know, media stuff. And he's done it for the Cars Tour as well. So he's got a lot of energy. He brings a lot of good ideas.
Mm-hmm.
And he's got two, you know, pairs of shoes to fill.
Yes.
But I think he's got the energy to do it. I'm looking forward to it. I didn't, everybody, where was Doc? Where's Doc? You know, he works here. He's supposed to be here. I didn't have a duty last weekend. So, you know, they bring their own announcing crew, their own, you know, truck for production. So I didn't have nothing to do. So couldn't afford to go up there for no pay.
And see there, you didn't get to see Deac win that race.
Yeah, I did. I watched it on Flow. It was awesome.
Yeah.
I mean, I bet there was not, everybody was cheering for you. You know, there's, especially at South Boston, you got fans that are diehard Lane Riggs fans, and you got fans that are diehard Peyton Sellers or, you know, other drivers. All of those drivers, when you're getting ready close to win a race, all of those fans cheer for you, Deac.
That's
got to make you feel pretty special, man. You're one of those guys that everybody wants to see do well.
Well, since we're tooting your horn, Deac, I will say this. I met Bradley through Kale Gale and Bubba Gale. And because the reason you probably don't know this, and hell no, you don't know this. But anyway, the reason I'm here is because of Kale and Bubba, and I've been doing Kale's PR for humpteen years. And Kale today was going to the dirt track to do some data acquisition stuff for Garrett Smith. And I was like, you know, hey, Deke's going to be on tonight, Kale. He said, that's a good boy. You know, Kale, that's how he's, that's a good boy. So yeah,
that's pretty cool.
But anyway, man, look, it's awesome to have you on tonight. I appreciate it. Not Love hooked this up. I'd actually messaged you and your wife's page. And then Doc had said, well, I can text him. And I was like, heck yeah. So man, it means a lot to me for you being on this show. And, you know, you got one for the working man's way I look at it. You know, you, like Doc said, you got a lot of people that enjoy watching you race, and it was cool with your family. But at the end of the day, there's a lot of people involved, and I want you to please take that this time to thank everybody.
Yeah, I appreciate it. You know, definitely big shout out to Marcus Richmond and Arness Race Cars. You know, I couldn't do it without them. Him and Steve Stallings, everybody up there at R&S is just a huge help for me. And David West at John West Racing Engines for just supplying me with great horsepower and Prager tank lines, Blackgate Hunting Products, Brandon Ernest at Ernest Performance, Bradley at Graphics Unlimited, and Bobby Gregory Weldon, and just all my guys on the crew, man. We just, like I said, we're one big family and working hard to keep this thing up front. Hopefully we can get a few more strong runs toward the end of this year.
Would you believe it if I told you that Brandon Ernest himself has sat right here with Sidney Sanders is and co-hosted with me?
Mm-hmm. That's awesome. Yeah, Brandon's a good guy. He's helped me out a lot this year.
Do you think we piss some people off? Yes or no? Do you think we cared if we piss somebody? Yes or no? Well, anyway, man, hey, I wish you nothing but the best, man. I hope our paths cross pretty soon. But if not, you know, happy Halloween, Thanksgiving, Merry Christmas, and all that good stuff. And you're more than welcome to be on here anytime, Deke.
10-4, man. I appreciate you guys having me on.
See ya. Deke McCaskill with the 10-4.
That was cool.
I like that. 10-4. That was cool. He kind of reminds me of Jeremy Mayfield.
He's such a good dude.
He looks really young.
His whole family is just fantastic.
Did you say look, really young?
He looked young in his photo.
Did he?
You didn't have your glasses on. It's okay.
to watch his daughters at the racetrack, that is entertainment in itself.
Oh, yeah.
Really animated. And I meant to ask him, I think his youngest daughter raced our Virginia State Police Hornets.
Huh?
State Police Hornets.
What does that mean?
At South Boston. So that's a front wheel drive class.
Oh, that's the name of the class. I thought she'd run from the cops or something.
She probably would.
Dang, Deke, you making them wild over there, ain't you, son?
I think it's his youngest daughter raced with us a couple times. That was awesome to see.
All right. So coming up next, it's going to be Kevin Kromer of the Grand National Super Series. We'll be right back. Y'all don't go nowhere. Like I say all the time, if you do, y'all come on back. I see you there, Dead Jeremy Tiddley. Them dang Raiders got him a win, boy. But he's right. Garoppolo sucks. Josh McDaniel sucks. 4th-and-1 with 2-minute warning. And they want to kick a field goal?
Well, they tried it.
And it didn't work. You should have watched it. We'll be right back. Y'all don't go nowhere.
What's this song?
This segment is brought to you by H&H Auto Repair, located in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. H&H Auto Repair is your one-stop auto shop. They're located at 3088 Kernersville Road in Winston-Salem, family-owned and operated for over 20 years. There's no job too big or too small.
H&H Auto is also an official North Carolina inspection station. Whether it's an oil change or an engine swap, go by and see the guys at H&H Auto. And be sure to tell them OCC sent you. H&H Auto Repair, 3088 Kernersville Road, Winston-Salem, North Carolina.
I thought she didn't like it. At first, when he pulled up the Chicago Bears, I thought it was baseball.
Hey, it's Brandon Ernest with Ernest Performance. You're listening to Race 22 Radio.
Well, I took a walk around the world to ease my troubled mind. I left my body lying somewhere in the sands of time. But I watched the world flow to the dark side of the moon. But I feel there's nothing I can do.
Yeah.
I don't know. If I go crazy, then will you still call me Superman? Is that that song? Is it?
Well, they don't say Batman and Robin.
Well, I was just asking. If you had the chorus, then I could sing it.
Wait. Oh, me, oh, my. Appreciate y'all tuning in tonight. Oh. My co-host, Sydney Sanders. What are you doing over there?
Jordan said my peeps.
Jordan Atkins is watching.
It's Jordan-Ann.
Jordan-Ann. About time she tunes in. Jordan, thank you for tuning in. She is the owner, the operator, the whatever needs to be done with Squeaky Clean Express and ceramic coatings. I forgot to say coatings. I forgot to put it on there for you to say. So anyway.
Okay.
Thank you for tuning in, Jordan. Coming up next, we got Kev. Is he on the line? He is. That's good. Matter of fact, I pretty much knew he would be here. Kevin, how are you, buddy?
I'm doing good. How about you?
Aww. Kevin, you know the answer to that. Fat and happy, and I love cheeseburgers.
Absolutely. That's why I asked.
All right, those of y'all listening, this is Kevin Kromer. He races in the Grand National Super Series. And but not just Kevin has raced in ARCA. He has been a Super Cup champ. He has done – there's not much that Kevin hasn't done. And we're going to be racing Kevin in the Grand National Super Series. Their championship night will be this Saturday night at Carteret County Speedway. And most of y'all that watches this show knows I got to go and hang out with these guys and call their race on their YouTube channel the weekend before last at Dominion. And, man, Kevin, that wasn't a good night for you, was it, buddy?
No, it wasn't. It wasn't. My other car won, so that was a good deal with Jake Christman in it. But as far as my concern, no. We unfortunately ended up in the front straightaway wall at the most inconvenient time. And we broke something in the steering. And that pretty much ended our night in that car and cost me a 12th place finish. But we came back in the other one and finished third. So we made a good night out of it anyway.
Right. So once again, I'm telling you, Sydney and Dot Love, remember we had Jake Christman last weekend or last show, actually. Uh-huh. Then he had won, and it was Kevin Kromer's car that he won. And if you remember, I was talking about, I am 99.999% sure that there was only five cars on the lead lap in that race. Am I right on that, Kevin? Do you know?
I really don't know. I was watching them, and I was really happy what was transpiring. But I was still a little frustrated with what happened with me. So
absolutely.
I wasn't really watching what he was doing.
Absolutely. So, Kevin, this weekend in the championship race, are you going to race your regular 77? Is it going to be back race ready?
No, I'm actually bringing the car that Jake drove. That car there, just it needed a little bit more work than what I anticipated. And things were just a one- and a two-man-person team at home here. It takes a lot for me to get everything ready. So it would have been a lot of work to get two cars ready. So we're just going to bring the one car this weekend.
And Jake's not going to be there as well, right? I mean, he had a prior obligation, I do believe.
Yeah, he's like third in points in the ROC in New York. So he'll be running his car that weekend.
What is the Grand National Super Series working with Bob Shack and Miss Patty? AJ Hendrickson, Mayfield, Kitzmiller, the people involved with this series, and you know, and I'm talking about from the top to the bottom. And this is something I've learned at Dominion. It's like a big happy family, and you don't get a lot of what I've seen. And being I got to be a small part of it, and gonna get to do it again this weekend. It and I said it to Miss Patty, everybody that I've even talked to, and I said it to Jake last weekend. And to AJ, is the family atmosphere that this series has is second to none. And for a touring series like y'all are, I think that's a must. You must have that, and y'all definitely do.
Yeah, absolutely. That's what makes it so much fun, and it's not real stressful. We go there, we have a pretty good time. Things do transpire that, you know, you get a little irritated with different things, but at the end of the night, it's all over with and we move on to the next race. But without that family atmosphere, we would not be able to do what we do.
Now, Kevin, Chris was saying earlier that your wife does a lot of hands-on spots, cooks, works the jack. Is she pretty much your only crew that you have at the track?
Sometimes, you know, I live probably besides the Mopar Mafia, I probably travel the farthest.
Uh-huh.
And it's hard to get my guys at home here to go because it requires them taking off of work. You know, I'm self-employed. I can pretty much go when I want to go. It's just, you know, it's so pretty much, yeah, it's her. And she helps me in the shop too a lot. You know, she helps me set tow and she'll help me jack the car up. And she'll even sit in the car when I scale it if I need a little bit, you know, to get more accurate weight. And not that she weighs as much as me. It's just, she just helps me do everything. At the racetrack, she really does a lot of things. She spots. She'll keep my time. She'll cook. She'll, I don't know. She just keeps everything rolling.
That's awesome.
Heck yeah. You should have seen the buffet they had out the other night at the end of the race. I mean, that was awesome. I mean, of course, I was watching Alabama football, but it goes back to the togetherness and the, you know, it reminds me of wrestlers in a way. Y'all out there beating
what?
And banging.
What?
Wrestlers.
Wrestler?
Y'all go to hell. It reminded me of how they, you know, they're out there beating and banging and racing against each other. And then you go to the lobby of the hotel and everybody's hanging out, eating, high-fiving and cheers and what have you. This weekend, y'all going to have your championship banquet. And I am really excited about getting to be a part of that. Kevin, do you have a favorite track on the Grand National Super Series tour?
I pretty much do very, very well at all of them. The only one I really ever had a lot of trouble with was Tri-County, but we sort of got that one straightened out. But I love the Run Dominion. That is a first-class facility. I really like that track. I won there quite a few times in the other series. But as far as like Carteret and New River Goodyear All-American, I forget what they call them. But
you was right.
I like them two tracks. You know, they're flat. They're a driver's track. You can't just go there and, you know, they're a little technical. And I enjoy that. It puts a challenge on the drivers. It makes it for an interesting race because you don't always have to have the best car and you can run up front at those tracks because of just the way they're designed.
You're always on the wheel, especially at Carteret. I know that.
Absolutely.
Kevin, I want you to... There's one of your sponsors, of course, at the end of when we're done talking, I always give the opportunity to thank your sponsors, everybody's involved. But I'm going to get ahead. I'm going to put the cart before the horse. I want you to tell the listeners about BACK, BACK, one of your sponsors.
All right. That's Bikers Against Cop Killers. And it's what we do is I'm actually a member of that group. Is what we do is we do a lot of fundraising rides and different things, and all the money gets distributed to first responders. It gets, you know, distributed if people need medical help or, you know, to pay medical bills or to buy equipment. It just goes to all the first responders, whether it's fire, ambulance, police. We just
donate most all the money to something, you know, like, and it doesn't necessarily have to be in our area. It can be in any area that anybody needs help.
That, when I heard y'all talking about that the first time, it was pretty cool. And that's your son's an officer, isn't he?
Yes.
That's awesome.
He's a canine officer.
That's telling him we appreciate his first service. Yep. So, but yeah,
yep, I thought. Exactly. Go ahead.
Say again.
I said he's not here. I just probably just got off of work a little bit ago. So he doesn't always come home. Most of the time he goes to his fiance's place. So
yeah,
I will tell him when I see him.
Yeah, when you tell him that old crazy Chris Carter and sitting with people at talking circles, we really appreciate his service, even though it's not where we're at, but it's put on that badge and do what they do every day. And especially in today's world, I was at the fair the other night. I don't care if I'm in McDonald's. I don't give a rat's behind where I'm at. I will thank an officer for his service. Always will. And that's just the way it is. So
we support the blue.
If we only had a clue of what they got to deal with, you know, I always talk about people don't deserve internet access and idiots. You know, I could imagine being an officer having to deal with a bunch of idiots like they have to deal with.
Yeah, I mean, we don't really know half of what he deals with. He just says a little bit here and there.
Yep.
And he does not elaborate on anything.
So this weekend, Twin 50s, Carteret County Speedway. Last time that
Twin 50s. You were
Twin 50s, that's what they do. That's what they race, Twin 50s. The last time that I was announcing at Carteret County Speedway and Kevin Kromer was racing, after the second race, I brought a broom.
He swept it. Yes, he swept it.
That was a night that I'll never forget. And he was about halfway through that race. And I even told you this, Kevin. I said, he's going to win this race. And I started looking for a room. And I made AJ, the guy that keeps everything clean, walks around and said, AJ, I need a broom.
I bet his arms were worn out.
He said, Mr. Chris, what you need a broom for? I said, I'm going to sweep the grandstands. Just get me a damn broom. But anyway, excuse me. If there's a possibility we could see it again this weekend, Kevin?
There's always a possibility, but you know, the competition in this series is very, very tough. If anybody watches our times when we qualify, you can throw a blanket over the top 10 cars. Mm-hmm. It's not an easy task to win these races. And when you do win one, it's well appreciated because of the competition you're up against. I mean, AJ's one, you know, AJ's tough to beat. Kit Smeller, Jeremy, when he's on, he puts manners to me all the time. It's just a really, really competitive series.
Here's the thing about it. The series is growing and it's going to be even more competitive, in my opinion.
Yeah. I mean, the amount of cars that showed up at Dominion, there were 12 cars that were within probably a tenth, you know, and that's how competitive is, you know, you got to be right on the game, but it makes it interesting. It makes good racing. Bob really has the rules really put together that we can run different motor combinations and nobody really runs away from anybody. So, you know, he really does a good job at making sure we all stay on a level playing field.
Exactly. That speaks volumes about Bob Shack's intelligence with a race car and what's going on, which in my opinion, when you're running and you're in charge of a series that tours, it's very important because a lot of times some of this can get out of hand, you know? Okay. Mr. Smith, you can run that for this, you know, and then, you know, but he's fun to be around, but by golly, don't piss him off. Just do what you're told and, you know, go by the rules and you'll be fine. Yeah, exactly. You know, he's serious when it's time to be serious and he's a lot of fun when it's time to have a lot of fun, but kudos to him and Miss Patty that they're keeping this thing like they're keeping it with the competition so close, in my opinion.
Yeah, it takes a lot of what Patty and Bob do, and they're on top of everything. I mean, you know, we step out of line, you know, he's right there to tell us, either him or Patty, and most of us stay in line pretty good. And like I said, he really did his research before any of this came about, and you don't find a much more competitive series than what we're running right now.
I agree. The Cars Tour is close. Y'all are close. That's two of the top ones, in my opinion. And I'm not talking bad about no other touring series, but it's very, these times, like you said, a 10th, you know, first through 10th is close competition. Yes. Know what I mean, Sydney?
Yep.
Well, I when are y'all leaving? Tomorrow? I mean, y'all got to drive like 3 days.
Yeah. We'll probably leave Thursday after work, and I'll go as far as Dominion or maybe a little farther, stay over, and then finish it off Friday morning so gotcha. I can get there by Friday afternoon.
So how far is your drive?
To Carteret.
It's about, I think like 590 miles.
Okay, how many hours is that?
Yeah.
How many hours is that? Probably 12.
Oh.
So AJ, and AJ, now I talked to Jen today. And I think that her and AJ, they're taking the motorhome, and it's 16 hours. Does that sound right, Kevin?
Yeah, because they're a little bit farther north than me, northwest. But yeah, so yeah, it's probably 16 hours. It when I look stuff up, it tells me 10 hours or 12 hours. But when you're towing the trailer, you got to stop for fuel. I got to eat, you know. And yeah, believe it or not, I do got to eat. So it usually ends up, if it's a 10 hour trip, it takes us 12 or 13 hours.
Hmm. There you go.
I'm worn out. You just talking about it. And then you got to run 100 laps when you get there
the next day,
but still
that's easy. That's the easy part.
That's the part he loves. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's why he's driving all them hours, Sydney.
I know.
Well, man, I'm excited about this weekend. You know, we got the USAC Midgets also going to be there.
Yeah, I like watching them. They ought to put a pretty good show on.
Yes.
They probably get around there pretty good.
That's what I was thinking. Well, Mr. Kevin, I appreciate you being on. I love having you on here. I told you last time I seen you, I was going to have you on again, and here we are. And appreciate your support of Mr. Bob and him and being a part of that. I told Miss Patty, I texted her today, told her you was going to be on. And I feel very honored to be a small part of what y'all are doing. Looking forward to the banquet Sunday.
You going to wear a tie?
Yes, I'm going to wear a tie.
Does he own a tie?
I want pictures. You should wear.
Kevin, tell him how y'all dress for this banquet.
No lawn mowing. No lawn mowing clothing. If you know what that means.
That's right.
That's what JD puts on the thing, on the post.
It's going to be a good time.
I get casual. We're casual.
Yeah, there you go. I'm looking forward to it. Well, as always, if you would, take this time to thank everybody involved.
Okay. First and foremost, I got to thank Bob and Patty and AJ and Jen and everybody at ECC, because without them, this wouldn't be possible.
Yes.
And, you know, Bob Shack Motorsports, he's helped me a ton over the past year since I joined the series to get me in competitive with what we're doing. And then we have Hal that sponsors our Charger Award, which gives us gift certificates that we can buy ball joints and parts from. So it's really great of them to do that. Especially, you know, like I said, ECC, because they really step up and do what needs to be done so we can have this, you know, this good series that we're having, especially the Anchor Bolt Triple Crown. That is a really excellent 3-race series that I'm hoping that we finish very well on that too. And then I got my sponsors. You already said one, Bikers Against Cop Killers back. Line Decker Racing Engines. He gives me all the power we need. Versalift East, which does my graphics. And they also made the GNSS series logos in the windshields that we brought them. Krause's Classics, he takes care of my motorcycle. Nicholson Security, which does all our security work at our businesses. High Voltage, the ACDC Tribute Band, And Rick, that spots for me 90% of the time. A friend of mine, Pete, family, friends, and especially my wife, because without her, I wouldn't do it.
That's right.
Yeah. Miss Kelly, she's awesome. Miss Kelly's awesome.
She's a real MVP.
But and also, when y'all hear him say ECC, it's Engineered Components Company. It's the Grand National Super Series brought to you by Engineered Components Company. So that's when y'all hear him say ECC, that is who that is. I will see you on Friday, my friend. Looking forward to a great weekend of racing at Carteret County Speedway. And Mr. Kevin, y'all please be safe on your ride to Carteret County Speedway.
We'll take our time and we'll be safe. And I appreciate you having me on again. It's always good to talk to you, especially after the races. I think we had a pretty good talk there. I was getting hungry and we were still talking.
Well, all right. I'll see you Friday, buddy.
Okay. We'll see you.
Bye. Thanks.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Kevin Kromer, he's a good one. The whole series, like I said, it's Grand National Super Series. It's awesome. Engineered Components Company. They do a lot with them. All right, we're going to take a quick break. We're going to have...
It's very unique when you look at Bob and Patty that both of them have driven 200 miles an hour.
Yes.
That's very unique. Yes. When you look at driver and wife running a series or what have you. They both are fast.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
That's pretty awesome when you think about it.
Coming up next, he's 15 years old out of Decatur, Georgia, Gianni Esposito. Don't go anywhere. We're going to be right back in. We got Emma Britt coming.
Esposito.
You got a bed.
Is there an O? Is there an O?
Yes.
On the end.
No.
Okay.
I don't know. I can't. Wait a minute. Yes. Yes.
He doesn't have an O on his end.
I've got it, Hal. They've got it.
Okay, we're going to ask him.
No, we're not.
Jesus. Well, I'm looking forward to talking to him. It's going to be awesome.
Hey, did we tell you we'll be right back?
Cause it like the shit I do. Like my attitude. And I'm a real cool dude. It's taking me all the way. Go places I don't even want to go.
People can trust me to detail their vehicle because I've been doing it for years. I've worked on stuff from $1,000 all the way up to $100,000. But at the end of the day, you still got to live up to the same standard. I put love and care into every vehicle. I just want to make sure my customer's happy because I like getting everything. I mean, every crack, every cranny, anything I can get. I really just want it to be squeaky clean. I know how I want my ride to look like at the end of the day, and I should do the same thing to yours.
This is Jonathan Brown, driver of the Red, White, and Blue 22, and you're listening to Race 22 Radio. There's an innate. I'm not so innocent to think that you've been true. But I gotta know.
Carson Gray. Love that kid. She's going places. I'm telling you. Get to see her this weekend. Whoop, whoop.
Need to find out when her... next releases are going to be done so we can utilize those for her.
Absolutely.
She's awesome.
Absolutely. You ought to meet her. You ought to meet her in person. She isn't she? You know, you've met her. Mm-hmm. Very outgoing, awesome person. Her parents are too. Coming up now, is he on?
Yep.
Video?
Ta-da.
I can't wait.
Yes.
I can't. We're in such a delay. It's hard for me to. That okay. Hey. There he is, Gianni. Hey. How are you, buddy?
I'm good. How about you guys?
Man, I'm fat and happy. Sydney, she's just here.
Oh, that is so rude.
and Dot Love, he's my producer, and he's over there. For everybody listening, this is 15-year-old Gino Esposito out of, did I say it right, buddy?
Nope.
Gianni.
You said Gino.
Gianni.
Yes.
Esposito out of Dacula, Georgia. Yes. He's a 15-year-old Italian-American.
Out of where?
Dacula, Georgia.
Is that Decatur?
D-A-C-U-L-A. It's what his dad sent to me. That is where he's from. Dacula, Georgia.
Ah, I put Atlanta on his thing. Oh, I can't spell Dracula. Dracula, Georgia. Never heard of that.
Anyway, he's a 15-year-old Legends driver in the pro division. He started out racing speed carts, moved to Bandoleros. And by what your dad sent to me, he won his first race as a pro in a Legends car and is currently 11th in the nation. And I take it now you're going to go to a pro late model truck. Is that correct, Gianni?
Yes, sir. I'm driving the pro truck next year.
Yeah. So all this that you've done, when did you, you're 15 right now. First, how tall are you?
I am about 5'10".
Okay. Oh, okay.
For 15 years old, that's pretty tall.
And yeah. For an Italian American.
Yes.
That's tall.
That's yeah.
I imagine my grandfather's not that tall compared to us. So,
how old was you when you started racing, buddy?
I started at 7 years old, and I was racing at the K1 Speed indoor karting that you find at a lot of places. And I started out in the little program they have for the beginning of races, and you pay for it and stuff. And I was beating kids that were actually my age, and right now I was beating kids at seven. So the manager came up and was like, "Well, go talk to this guy named Ken Reagan at Lanimo Speedway and get into Bandolero cars." And this is where I am now. After Bandos, I went to Legends, and here I am.
Wow.
How do you like wheeling a Legend cars? Because it's well known, it's fact that a lot of drivers, and we can, from Kyle Busch to a lot of them, Joey Logano will tell you the same thing, is driving a Legend car seems to make a better race car driver. Was it hard for you to adapt to a Legend car?
I would say yes. Off the start, it was very difficult trying to go from a old lawnmower engine to a high-powered motorcycle engine with a car. It's very light, so it's very difficult to control your gas pedal and have the tires spinning at top speed. It's very difficult.
Wow.
Such a short wheelbase in that Legend car as well. Do you do any dirt racing with the Legend car?
No, sadly not.
Did you like to do some dirt racing in that Legends car?
Eventually, I want to try at least some dirt racing. And I thought it would make me a better driver and all.
Absolutely. Absolutely. No doubt about it. What you're in this Legend car. Do you have a favorite track that you race at?
Lanier. Lanier Motor Speedway is my favorite racetrack. It's very difficult. First of all, the front straightaway and back straightaway are not the same. One's wider than the other. Each turn is completely different. Different banking. It's a completely different racetrack. And they have the drifting there, which makes it extremely slick.
Wow.
I'm old, okay?
Yeah.
I'm going to let you know this. I'm old. So I thought Lanier, they were doing away with Lanier. Now, is Lanier the same Lanier when it was Lanier?
Yes.
It is?
Yeah, kind of. They don't have the inner wall anymore, but right. It's the same track.
Okay. Wow. So the few times, you're not going to believe this. You're not, and Dot Love is especially not going to believe this, but the few times that when I lived with Kale Gill that I would do iRacing in a Legends car, my favorite place was Lanier. I guess because Kale's won there so much, and we've been there so many times when he was coming up through the ranks. But I, for some reason, I thought Lanier. I knew they'd done the drifting,
yeah,
Gianni, but I didn't know that they were actually still racing Legends and that kind of stuff there.
Yeah, they're racing Legends there in Bandos, and hopefully by next year we have late model testing going back. Hopefully that'll be cool.
That was one of my favorite tracks back in the day, watching the Grand Nationals, the Busch Grand Nationals, going there on before they started going just to where the same track for Cup. That place used to produce some fantastic racing, and it's got to be fun going around that place with the Legend car.
Oh, it's I love that track. I would go there every day just to practice. It's
now, where do you plan on running your truck at?
down at Cordial, I'll try the Carolina Pro Truck Series as my main thing I might do next year, because that's where they, I'd say, produce the best drivers. So I was like, well, let's throw myself in the wolves and let's see how it goes.
Now, what was the transition like from go-karts to Bandoleros?
It wasn't that much different. The only difference it was is the turning. Yeah. Entrance into the turns was very hard because a Bando has a longer wheelbase. So it's harder to get the car to turn than a go-kart. But other than that, it was pretty much the same gas and brake. It was all momentum based. So there wasn't much change there.
Now, do you have your driver's permit?
Yes, I do. I'm hopefully December 27th. I'm going to get my license.
Do your parents get nervous when you drive in the car with them?
Sometimes, but they're a lot of times they just let me do it anyway because they trust me.
Well, that's good. That's good.
So in your family, are you the first generation racer?
Yes.
Anybody else in your family race?
No, nobody.
Because, you know, just hearing you talk and describe it, you know, from transition from one type of car to the other, you sound very calculated and your racing knowledge really seems to be really sharp. So it's like you do a lot of studying other than just driving, right? You study what's going on with the car and learning about the cars, right?
Yes, I like to work on my own car a lot of times just to learn what the car's doing at certain times. And I'll take a road car, for example, and just see what the comparative differences are and change it how I like the car to be, make it easier on myself.
I'm going to, I don't know you from Adam's house cat. There's a lot of guests on here that I've met, watched race and so on. Wasn't too long ago that I put a thing that because I love folks and you don't look like a kid. You don't act like a kid. You don't talk like a kid. You don't look 15. You don't talk 15. Okay. So, right, but yeah. I still consider you a kid. Okay. And when you first started talking and I listened to you speak, it didn't take me but about 2 minutes of listening to you speak, knowing why Frank messaged me confidently in having you on. And that's why I put the post up about having kids on and I see now why, what's the big dream here? Is it like everybody else? You just want to go racing and be in NASCAR?
I would love to be in NASCAR. If I can't make it to NASCAR, IMSA is my big other choice.
So what about a late model stock in the Cars Tour?
That would be amazing too. If I can win the Cars Tour, that'd be great. That'd be a big thing for me.
I think if you keep doing what you're doing and keep digging and keep making and being on podcasts like this, any kind you get an opportunity to speak and talk about what you've done, I think you need to keep on. The sky's the limit. I mean, your accolades and what I've read about you, and Frank is your dad, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, he's a proud dad, and he has every dadgum reason to be proud and he's, I mean, that's, I would be proud too. Hell, I don't know you and I'm proud of you, kid.
Yeah. Cause you know, just the way you present yourself, you know, talking to sponsors, you know, and trying to sell yourself to them, man, have you done that yet? Cause I really think you would knock it out of the park. I really do.
I'm trying. I've been going places trying to get people in contact. And like, I met this guy named Mason Mangio. I bought his Legends car. He said for every hundreds of emails, he'd get one guy to respond. He said he never gave up. So that's what I'm going to do.
You got to keep digging and you got to sell yourself. Nobody's going to do it better than yourself. Mm-hmm. And that's Kurt Britt's watching right now. And cause Emma's going to be on next. And that's why I like to have Emma on here. Emma sells herself. Don't get me wrong. That child can drive a race. She's 16. But that kid can drive. Yes. And she learned from Kurt. And Kurt, you know, I remember Kurt Britt and Kel Gale racing in the truck series at Lanier, speaking of, you know. So, I mean, I'm glad you came on. I'm you got a new fan now, buddy.
Thank you. Yeah. I have to say, Emma's one dang good driver. She's amazing. She talks to people like they're best friend, and she's amazing. Honestly, I'm glad you guys know her because she's really good.
So is this why Kurt Britt said, what are you doing Friday if it doesn't rain? Is that to you?
I think that's the Frank. I have no idea what's happening this weekend.
I thought he was talking to you.
Yeah.
I'm like, I thought he was talking to us. I was like, Kurt, you're going to be a Carteret.
I have no idea. They don't tell me till like the last
there
day.
There is a big chance of rain at Carteret. That's why I was like, I don't know who the hell's Kurt talking to here. Well, yeah.
I wanted to share a picture and ask about this. From the background, is that Hickory Motor Speedway?
Yes,
some running there. That's in Victory Lane. Did you win a race at Hickory?
No, I did a combine testing for E33 Motorsports, and I went to the combine and raced the pro truck there to see how well I did. I did pretty well, but you know, sponsors are everything, so we sadly couldn't go with them. But they loved me having there. They wish I would have been with their team.
Awesome.
That's got to be a good experience, so you know what to expect next time. And I think you're going to go a long way. You know, I've been around this sport for a long, long time. I know the goods when I see them. And when you can perform and talk as well as you are fast on the racetrack, that goes a long way in this sport. And a lot of young racers miss that part. And it sounds like you've already on top of your game. So I am so thrilled to hopefully see you progress and get some opportunities. I was looking at the chat. There's some folks. Is it Maria Saint ST? Says Gianni.
Just say Maria. Miss Maria.
Miss Maria. Miss Maria said Gianni is amazing. And Richard, I can't.
Just say Richard.
Napolitan.
Yeah, Napoleon.
There you go.
Napoleon. Out of mind there. He watched him race. He's amazing. So hearing things like that, you're going to gain fans, especially interact with. I know you've already, you know, interact with the fans, and that's going to go a long way because, you know, Emma does that as well.
Yeah, thank you. I try my best. I really do.
Well, now that we've tooted your horn, I'll see you later, buddy. Nice talking to you.
All right.
No, I'm picking. I wouldn't do that to you. I got to get you used to people like me out in this business, but
yeah,
hey.
Yeah, he's a wild one.
If you ever, let me share this, I don't know who's doing it, I will help you in any way possible. Sponsorship proposals, use me as a reference, okay?
Hey, I got a name I could say. Elizabeth Jackson says, so proud of Gianni. He is so amazing to watch. So, you see, you got some awesome fans. You got a good start of a good core fan base. And, man, the sky's the limit for you, young man.
Thank you. I love it here. It's nice talking to people. That's my favorite thing.
if we keep on, you're going to expect Christmas presents, I think. So
hold on. I got to choose between birthday or Christmas. My birthday's December 22nd, so I have to choose.
Cool. One big gift.
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much. That's just it.
Yeah, that's it. Well, look, man, I am coming up next. I do have Emma Britt, man. I'm so glad we're going to have you on again.
Yeah, we're going to keep track of your racing.
Definitely keep up with you. If I can help you, a reference, anything, whatever I can do, please let me know. I'll do whatever I can. Looking forward to seeing you race. I will see you race soon, buddy. I promise.
Thank you. I will. I'll see you then.
Well, let's not go away yet. Let's thank everybody involved.
Oh, yeah, I got to thank everybody. It's great seeing people. I think one thing that stood out for me was bikers versus, what's it called? Bikers versus?
Cop killers.
Cop killers. My family's law enforcement and fire department, so I love that. That helps out a lot. I like that. That it hits home big time. And everything else, everyone else that's here sponsoring them and keeping them in talk, they're great people. Keep it up. I mean, there's nothing else I can really say. They're really respectful. They're funny. I mean, awesome. And if they help people out, that'll help everyone else out. So it'll be amazing to see them do.
Who's all a part of your team?
Pretty much my family, anyone involved. I work with Doug Stevens for my racing team. So Doug Stevens, Scott Gorman. So for right now for Legends, that's them.
Appreciate you, buddy. And on, buddy. Looking forward to having you on again.
Thank you.
All right. See ya.
See ya.
Sharp, sharp young man.
Absolutely.
Looking forward to follow him.
My favorite is the Elizabeth.
Elizabeth.
I mean... I'm here going sanitary. I'm like, what the hell is she doing over here?
I was sounding it out.
That kid will never be on this show again.
He was thanking us. He was sweet, y'all.
He will never be on again. He was a
stage producer has checked in.
She would be a better co-host if y'all stayed off the phone.
When are we on our phone?
Apparently, all right. Is Emma on?
Yep. Let's go right to her.
They know each other. That's awesome.
Who?
Emma and Gianni. Gio, as you said.
Look, there she is. Girl, what are you doing?
What do you mean what I'm doing? I'm talking to the best people right now.
That's right.
How are you, Emma?
I'm doing great. How are you doing?
Well, you know the deal. Fat and happy, and I love cheeseburgers.
Oh, yeah. I love hearing that words from you. I look forward to it every time I ask.
So, look, you've been on our neck of the woods here lately. You've been at Richard Childress's. You've been at RCR. I'm a little mad, just a little bit mad that you've been so close to right here to where we're at in Winston.
She has.
And has we have not got to see you.
I'm feeling a little verklempt right now.
Hey, I promise I'll make it up to y'all next year. Hopefully there will be a lot more travel in the future. Hey, it's right around the corner before you know it.
Okay, yeah, that's true.
Because it's now off season, we got to get some cars built up. You know, I'm going into a new car next year, but I promise I'll make it up. I'll come hopefully see y'all a lot.
Yeah, you will. Well, Emma, catch us up. You have had a lot going on. You've got new things going. You're climbing up the ranks. You're being talked about. I see your picture everywhere. You're hugging on Richard Petty. I mean, fill us in, babe.
So, things that have recently been going on is we've done a little bit more traveling in the Carolinas racing. I mean, I've tried one new track, Southern National, and it was amazing. I want to rag on them a little bit. Facility, everything was lovely. Won there both times that I went. It was really awesome. And also, we, of course, went on our field trip for Speed U. Yes, that is a picture. It was amazing. I loved it so much. It's the owners, everything about that place. If you are looking for a racetrack to go watch on a Saturday, Sunday deal, that is the place. But back to what I was saying about the Speed U and the Ken Reagan field trip we just had. We went to RCR. We went to their race shop. I actually got to see Kyle Busch's car that he was racing for the Roval. Went there, saw that before. And Mike Dillon gave us a tour. I also got to meet the pit crew. It was amazing. And thank you to the people that do the Richard Childress Museum, because they were closed and they opened back up for us to go see around, which that was awesome.
That means she's VIP.
Thanks to Ken Reagan. He was really a helpful hand in all that. And he took us so many places. We went to Red Horse Racing. That was awesome to see how they do tire changes and all that. And it was really cool to see how they have the little racetrack, Score Mile. It's really cool. Something else was going to meet Richard Petty, going to his garage. He was awesome. Yes. Mm-hmm. He was really a true legend. It was awesome to meet somebody how he made it up, his story. It was awesome. It was really cool.
Did he give you some advice?
It was more of like yes. It was, because when he gave us our story, it was a really good thing to like hear his story and also just how he made it. And it's really inspirational. I'll say that.
Richard,
that was a lot of advice in itself.
Richard Petty will talk to any human that can talk, like you fought in Vietnam with him or something. He is the same way it's the truth. Look, if you had a friend with you and you could go up and say, "Hey, Richard, how are you? Hey, son, what you been up to?" He'll go right along with you. And that's the beauty of that man. First time I met Richard Petty, you're not going to believe this, Emma, but I'm going to tell you anyway. Well, you know me. Yeah, you will believe it. It was in Biloxi, Mississippi. It was the Kyle Petty charity ride. And me and my buddy Johnny Scott, who was the crew chief for Bubba Gale's race car at Mobile International Speedway, we went down the elevator, and the elevator opened. And there Richard Petty was. No sunglasses, no hat.
Did you recognize him?
You dadgum skippy, I did. And I said, "Sir, can I have a picture?" And he said, "Boy, I just..." And look, It was a pocket cameras back then. Okay. This is how long ago this was. He went, boy, I just don't know. I don't know. I got to get up there and get my hat. I said, come on, Mr. Richard, let's take one picture. Johnny took the picture of us, and that picture's missing in Hurricane Katrina somewhere. Dadgummit.
One of the few. That'd be awesome to have one of the few pictures without his hat and sunglasses.
Yes.
That'd be kind of like the picture of Dale Earnhardt without his mustache.
Yeah. Is there one?
There is one floating around there.
Wow. So, you, Emma, you have just been – are you keeping Kurt Britt straight?
That's a really hard question. You know that that's hard. He's been really good. He has been – he's busted his tail on my car. I mean, after my hard hit at Florence, it was crazy to watch how, like, that racer kicked in, him and Hunter Jordan's dad fixed my car. Like, he's really been, like – when I wanted to go, I got hurt and I still wanted to go back out. I'll just say this. He has been the best dad. He gets best dad of the year award. Like, he has worked his tail off for me this year. I haven't wrecked a lot, fingers crossed, because the year is still not over. I got one more race left in the bando.
And where's that?
But it's at Cordell this weekend, which was just pretty special to my heart because that's where I had my first race and I'll have my last one. And it's just been an incredible journey. I'll say he's been the best dad this year. He's took me everywhere, and we've performed really well everywhere we've went, and it's been awesome. So, yes, he's been been on the straight.
Good guy. He is. He was a heck of a wheelman, too. So what do you think about this, Emma Britt? Bubba Pollard, new podcast, BSing with BP. Have you heard about it?
I heard a little bit about it. I heard little rumors. But that is incredible. I love that. I hope to be on it one day. That's my goal.
I promise.
Yeah.
I promise, Emma Britt, you will be on it. Yeah. I promise.
Thank you. I'm holding you to that. I'm holding you to that.
I got enough pull with him that you'll be on there. I'm not, you know that. Girl, you're going to be on there. I think it's going to be really interesting because there's a side of Bubba Pollard that a lot of people don't know about that they're going to get to learn. And if I'm sure he'll be Bubba, but you know. A lot of people don't look at Bubba as a talkative media type people. Having to deal with him in the past, he's like, okay, we're done. Bye. You know, he's not one to deal with.
Almost like learning more about him than just the racer side, is what you're saying?
Yeah,
like
yes.
And that's awesome.
Yeah, I'm excited about it. I was going to have him on tonight, but I'm going to wait. All right. So you've got one race this weekend at Cordell. It looks like there's a chance of rain. What if it does rain out? Do y'all get to race the next week or you'll still get one more race?
So I don't know what their schedule and planning is because of considering the time of when it's all going on and stuff. And I believe that they have a bunch of bigger cars on the schedule as well. So I'm sure it will get rescheduled for like probably the next weekend and something like that, which I'm sure that if it does get rained out, we'll be posting the new date. Mm-hmm. But yes, I'll be running. If they have it rescheduled, I'll run that race.
I'm so excited for you.
Yeah.
I really am.
Yeah.
Let me look over here to my co-host, Sydney. Since you're female and this is a young lady, 16 years old, would you like to ask her anything?
What's your goal in racing?
My goal is to make it as far as I can possible. I have a dream and I'm trying to chase it. And I really have the strong mindset to never give up. So that is truly, I want to go as far as I can. I'm never going to give up until I get there.
That is a great mindset to have.
And I know where she gets that mindset. That the limb don't fall far from the tree. That's just like her daddy. Just like him. That's awesome.
What can I say? Great minds think alike. Yeah,
absolutely. Absolutely, kiddo. Well, it's always a pleasure to have you on. I just wanted everybody to hear from you and get caught up. You're one of our most favorite guests. Doc Love has something.
I saw you post on your social that you got a big announcement coming soon. Has that been made yet?
It hasn't been made, but it is definitely coming soon. Probably in the next week.
I was going to say, can you do it tonight?
On the show?
Of course on our show.
I really want to keep everybody on their toes, but I'll give a hint. Okay. It doesn't have to do with a different, like a bigger ride. That's my hint, is that it doesn't have to do with a bigger race car. Because everybody knows that I'm going to a legend car. That head post has been made. So that is the hint. because I saw a lot of people thinking I'm going to a bigger car, but it will be okay. Dad just said it was okay. So, sorry, I just saw his post because I didn't know if I was allowed to say anything because we were going to make a post. But considering this is my favorite podcast, no. I'll say it. We are going, I'm going to start my own podcast, and I'm really excited.
Awesome.
I don't know if it's going to be as big as the Chris Carter one, but I sure hope so.
That's awesome. Yeah. Well,
so now we're going to have Bubba Pollard, Emma Britt, Chris Carter.
Now, will it be live or recorded?
I'll probably do both. I really like live. I love face-to-face. Yeah. It's expressions. You can see more people's personalities. So I probably want to do that more or less too. I don't want to do just voice. I want to do live face-to-face and some in person too. Just a variety. All of that.
That sounds interesting. And I guess your dad, everybody's helping you. If they need any help or if they need some technical advice, just tell them to give me a call.
Yes, sir. Thank you. I appreciate that. Yes, my Mr. Jim has helped a lot. Who he comes to shop. He's an awesome man. And my dad, my mom, Southern Race will have been helping a lot. And I would really appreciate your help too. Any help I can get, any guidance, I would love to take. I love everybody's advice.
You can never get too much of it, kiddo. You're going to do fine. There's no doubt in my mind. And once again, this is why I enjoy having these younger kids on here. Is it just, you know, It opens doors and possibilities. And at the end of the day, the people like you, Emily, it's the future of our sport. I mean, and I start talking about, we're talking about goals and stuff like that, but in today's world with prices and everything and NASCAR being, I ain't going to go down that rabbit hole, but anyway, you know, it's feasible, especially with your dad's connections and stuff, that you could be racing in the Cars Tour that Dale Jr. owns here in the next 3 or 4 years easily.
Well, thank you. I really hope so. I know definitely I'll need some help with sponsors. If anybody's looking to sponsor somebody, I would really love to represent your business, your brand. I really need help with the sponsor part, but I'll promise you I'll perform. I'll put in the practice. I'll put in the work, and I'll definitely promote.
Yes, you will. That's it. There's a lot of people that would back that up.
And you know, you were talking about, learning about more about Bubba Pollard away from the track. Well, share with us something recently away from the track. Homecoming. How did that go? And didn't you both dance with your helmets on?
You know, that's a good point. I'll definitely have to do that at my next. That is a great point. Seth is going to love that. But so I do go to an online school, but we went to his homecoming. Unfortunately, we did not dance with our helmets, but we did get a bunch of pictures still at a racetrack, not really away, but we got a bunch, and also some more will be coming out soon on my Instagram. But it was awesome. We didn't dance with our helmets, but we did dance. We had a lot of fun.
That's cool.
That's cute.
Y'all are very cute together.
Thank you.
That is Seth Christensen. For those of y'all that doesn't know, that's who is in the picture there. He has been a guest on this show.
Mm-hmm.
And once again, he is another youngster that can wheel the holy crumbeco labeto out of a race car. I almost said a bad word with Emma.
How do you spell that?
I'll tell you later after I go to tea time and a Jaeger bomb.
Lord.
Oh,
hang out with all the what do they call it? The cornhole. They got cornhole tonight.
Oh, yeah?
Yep.
Well, I'm not going for that. Emma, don't act like Chris, though. Your dad will tell you. Don't. Just keep doing what you're doing. You're going places. I said it before. We all know it. And you're welcome on this show anytime. You can, like, Chris, can I be on? Yes, you don't even have to ask. And I appreciate you making that little announcement.
Yeah,
about your little podcast. That's awesome that you made it here on this podcast. So we're bonded forever.
That's right.
We're bonded forever, Kurt Britt. Emma, who all you want to thank?
So the first person I would like to thank is, of course, the Lord above, that he has blessed me with so many opportunities this year. I've more than I could ever have imagined. I feel so blessed, not only with the opportunities, but the people I've met and the journey I've been on. But also, I would like to thank my dad. I would like to thank Cirque Motorsports. And I would also like to thank, let's see, I'm trying to think of old things. I also want to thank my mom And I also want to thank, there's so many people that have really helped me this year. That's why I'm thinking to say, oh no, I've really, like, everybody has chipped in to help me so much. And it has been, I've been nothing but thankful for that. Adrenaline Power Sports. I would also like to thank ZMAX, and I would like to thank the Copenex group. They have helped me tremendously through this journey. And I would also like to thank my grandma and my grandpa and my grandma and my brother. He's came to the races more. It has been an incredible experience. He's actually gotten out of his shell more, which that means the world. And just really everybody. Everybody has chipped in. It's just been wonderful. I really cannot say that enough. I know I keep freezing up, but it's truly like I can't even say everybody has really put in a lot of effort this year. And most of all, the people that I really like to thank is Lenny and Shayna. Shayna's not doing well right now, and I'm praying for her, but he is almost like a second dad to me. He just took me to Lanier the other weekend when I got that feature win. My dad had to go two separate places. He chipped in a lot. It's truly just been, everybody has been helping me a lot, and I cannot thank that enough.
You got it going on, kiddo. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep smiling. Keep thanking the Lord above, and you're going places, I promise you.
Thank you.
We'll be in touch, and I hope to have you on again soon.
Thank you so much. I've enjoyed this so much. Y'all are the best.
See you, kiddo. Bye. Be safe.
Bye.
She is so sweet and got the talent to back it up.
Oh, yeah. That's no doubt about that.
Good family. Good family. And with all those folks chipping in when dad has to be away, that shows there's a lot of people that believe in her as we believe in her. We definitely believe in her.
Do you ever get freezing cold at the end, toward the end here?
Yes.
I mean, I'm almost like, it gets cold. It's like, it's okay when you walk in.
It's perfect.
Yeah, whatever. Yeah, and then my sponsors over here, when we had the 16-year-old guest on, man, I can't even, once again, they're so out of line.
It's like they're ignoring the show and having no doing their own thing.
They are.
Just let them have their own conversation.
Don't forget, before we move on, don't forget, you got the nice thing going on at Carteret. Plus, for all the modified fans, they are at South Boston Speedway this weekend, 3:00 green flag. So get up there early. And the Carolina Pro Crate modifieds are running with them as well. So plus they got the Southern Ground Pounders running their both divisions. So it's going to be a great day. Modifieds at South Boston Speedway this weekend. Don't forget.
Also coming up October the 29th. Let me do this one first. Okay. October the 22nd, Bryant Robertson, Turn and Burn Hobby and Raceway. They're having a dirt off-road Halloween race. $30, mm-hmm. $25, $15. Biggest class, first place, $100. Second, $75. Third, $50. Second biggest class, $50 for first. Second is $30. Third is $20. Cash payout. Dot love. That's right down your alley. So Sunday, October the 22nd, all you remote control RC enthusiasts, y'all, Danny Stockman was there last weekend, yep. Bryant told me.
Yep, there's a lot of folks, top crew chiefs, crewmen that have raced in these parts. I've known Danny for a long time.
Also, we're going to have a cruise in at Turn and Burn Hobby and Raceway Sunday, October the 29th. From 2 to 6 p.m., they're going to have classic cars, hot rods, modern cars, exotic imports, rat rods, motorcycles, race cars, car clubs. Welcome. Asphalt RC Oval Race. There's going to be a $100 giveaway to a lucky winner, and that's going to be on October the 29th, Sunday, at Turn and Burn Hobby and Raceway, which is at the Midway Town Center, 11141 Old U.S. Highway 52, Suite 10. You'll see all the cars will be out there. Also, the Alabama beat Texas A&M and the New Orleans Saints won. Daniel Harrison's Dallas Cowboys lost. Green Bay Packers lost.
Two in a row.
There we are. Roll Tide.
Bless his
heart. All right, so here we are. We're going to do y'all don't forget, this weekend, Carteret County Speedway, as Dot Love was just saying, Night of Champions this weekend. We're going to have the USAC midgets. So that's going to be pretty awesome to see the midget cars at Carteret County Speedway, plus the Grand National Super Series. Night of Champions. We'll hope to see that Haley Brown cheering for her in her quest to win championship. As he said, I did have it in my notes, actually, Dot Love. Smart Modifieds at South Boston. That'd be a good one to go to if you can't make it out to Carteret County Speedway. Also, tomorrow at 5 o'clock, Bob Lowry will be making an announcement concerning November the 12th race, correct?
That's right.
November the 12th, Race of Champions. November the 11th, we're going to have the Mini Stock Nationals there, so we'll hope y'all be that. But tomorrow at 5 o'clock, Bob Lowry is going to make an announcement concerning the November 12th race, Race of Champions, paying $10,000 to win. He's going to tell you all about it. So there you go. I told Daniel Harrison I will be at a certain place by 9:30, and by golly, I'm going to be there.
You are going to make it on time.
I'm going to be there. Hold on. Let's see here what these numbnuts has been saying. I swear to God. Derek Wormwood, she's in your closet. What? So hard. This all started with Zach Brewer. Actually, Jason Riles said Zach's trolling for coil wires. It took you a minute, huh, Dot Love?
Yeah.
It took you a minute. It
took me just a couple seconds.
But anyway, Seth Christensen, he was watching, of course, with Amazon. Great show tonight. I appreciate all the guests, all my sponsors, talking about that with Daniel Harrison, H&H Auto, Jason Rowell with Colfax Towing and Auto Repair, and tonight's Deac McCaskill segment brought to you by Cogar Plumbing, and as always, our Kim Corner segment, which is our first one with Kenan Brown, brought to you by Pulliams Hotdogs and BBQ, and my wonderful co-host is going to give you a rundown of all the other people and everybody involved.
Perfect. H&H Auto Repair in Winston-Salem, Pulliams Hotdogs in Winston-Salem, Wake Tree Service serving the Triad area, Tea Time Sports and Spirits in Winston-Salem, Burke Street Pub also in Winston-Salem, the Captain's Retreat at Bear Creek, Squeaky Clean Express and Ceramic Coating in Winston-Salem, Velocita USA and Motorsports on Main in Lexington, DL Outfitters, Colfax Towing and Auto Repair, Cogar Plumbing, Ever Ready Mixed Concrete, J&T Services, CNC Lock and Key, Thunder Road Grill, Midway Mobile Storage, Midway Music Hall and Event Center, Five Points Tire and Auto, Eric Messer Photography, and Make TV Great with Nate.
That's going to do it. We're going to be back next week. We're going to have some more kids on, and we're going to have another great show. I promise you that. Look for somebody, a big name to be on. That's all I'm going to tell you. Y'all come see us at Carteret County Speedway if you can. We're 2 miles from the Emerald Isle Bridge, so there you go. Looking forward to it. Thank you. Appreciate you. Thank you. Love. Thank you. Appreciate you. Worm, Jason Rowell, Daniel, all y'all's crazy tales. Thank you for tuning in as always. Daniel, I'm headed to you know where. I'll see you there. And we'll see y'all next Tuesday night here at Talking Circles with Chris Carter.
We thank you for clicking on Talking Circles with Chris Carter on Race22 Radio.
Race22 Radio.
We hope you have enjoyed the show and hope to see you back with us next Tuesday at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We hope to see you at a short track in your hometown. Until then, we'll see you at the races.